Today we're going to take apart the 2014 version of the Moto G with the camera on the right side. The original version of the Moto G has the camera on the left side. To start off, we're going to take off the back plate. I just start down by the charging port, and either use a pry tool or your fingernails, and you can just take off the back plate, sliding your fingernails around the back side. It's just a piece of plastic, don't need to worry too much about it, pops off pretty easily. There's a ton of screws around the back side as well. Take those off. I believe it's a T5 Torx head that you need to remove that. The tools will be in the video description below. You can see a bunch of copper pads on the underside of this as you take it off. Those are for the antennas as well as the earpiece speakers. Take off the earpiece connection as well as the front-facing camera, and this piece of tape covers the LCD connector. Lift up the black little flap, and that will allow you to remove the LCD ribbon cable from the motherboard. Lift off the SD card and SIM card ribbon cable. It's kind of like a little Lego connection that holds it to the motherboard. Then you can take your pry tool and slide it underneath the ribbon cable, and make sure not to bend it or kink it too much, or else you might damage it. I will try to link all of the replacement parts in the video description below. It looks to me like this vibrator motor is attached to the ribbon cable. So to lift that out, make sure you grab it from the bottom and lift it with the tweezers. You can see there's a little bit of glue attached to it as well. So if you do end up having to replace that, make sure you connect it securely in the same way that it looks right now. Then I take the copper sticker from the back of the battery and lift it up. This will allow us access to the battery so we can swap that out. Try not to rip this. If you do end up ripping it, you can just kind of piece it back together, making sure copper touches copper. To unconnect the battery, lift up on the little connector, similar to a Lego, and pop that out. And then remember, as you're prying up the battery, it is held on by tape underneath. Remember that you are prying against the LCD screen, so try not to put too much pressure underneath it, or else you'll end up cracking your LCD if it's not already broken. Slid my pry tool up towards the top, and make sure not to bend the battery or puncture it at all, or else it'll start smoking and melting and will probably damage something important. There's a battery. I will link replacement parts in the video description below. There's three screws, same size, the T5 Torx. Get those out, and then you can see underneath this little tape is the camera, held in place by the same little Lego connectors you've been removing this whole time from the rest of the phone. Pop that off, and you can see it right here. I believe it's an 8 megapixel camera. Pretty straightforward to reconnect it. Just pop it into place and press it down with your hand, and then put over that little tape shield when you're done with it as well. If you're going to replace a charging port, the only way to do it is with a solder gun and specialized tools. So good luck with that. And then the earpiece and the front camera will just lift out from the frame of the device as well. Here is the front speaker. The bottom speaker is the exact same, just lift up from the bottom and it's held in place with some clear tape. Pretty straightforward. I'm going to put that in back inside the frame. Now here's the screen itself. This is the screen and the frame combination combined, and this is the part that you would want to buy. If you do end up buying just the screen without the frame, it is a little bit harder of a replacement. You have to heat up the screen and the frame and then separate the two, and then use sticky tape to place the new screen down inside of the frame. The parts that I've seen listed that are sold with the frame itself are only about $10 more, so I think it's way worth your time to just go with the frame screen combination instead of just trying to go with the screen itself. It's very worth your time. Anyway, set the motherboard down in place after putting the camera and earpiece back into the frame. One little trick I learned is if you take your screwdriver and hold it up against the speaker, it's actually a little magnet and it'll magnetize your screwdriver so you don't have to lose your little screws as you're putting them back in. Get the three little screws around the motherboard back into place, and you can grab the battery, clip it down onto the motherboard, and then set the battery into place after that, making sure that it lines up with the little slots in the frame. That way you don't have any issues when you're trying to put that back plastic plate back on your device. Lock down the ribbon cable connectors for the front earpiece and the front camera, and then you can take your little copper shield and set that back over the motherboard and the battery. This kind of just shields your SD card and SIM card from interference with the device itself, as well as provides a little grounding plate. I put the vibrator motor in first and then clip the top next to that little SD card reader, and then I set the rest of the plate down after that. To get the LCD ribbon cable, I just grab it with my little tweezers and line it up with the slot and then lock it down into place as I'm holding it to make sure that's secure, and then take the little tape and put it in over the top of that as well. The little back plastic plate will help hold that down into place. Grab your little buttons. They have a little black tab on top that rests against the motherboard. These probably fell out at the beginning of the repair, so make sure you keep track of those. If your camera lens ever breaks, that little silver part just pops off. I will try to link replacement parts down in the video description below, and you can just re-adhere it with the adhesive that comes with the new lens. Put all those little screws back into place, pop that back cover back on, and you are set. If you have any questions, make sure to leave them down in the comments below. Also, read the comments before you do the repair. A lot of people have suggestions, maybe things I forgot, that'll help you out. And don't forget to like the video if it helped you, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you around.